College of Saint Chiamaka, computer teacher. This is just on computer studies. Hope you are safe. Before I start, get your writing materials. Okay, let's do a little exercise. No, it's still morning. Stand up, sit, stand, sit. It's okay. No, you're enjoying it already. All right, the previous term, I taught you input and output devices. Mention 5 input devices. Okay, I can hear keyboard, I know. Mouse, scanner, light pen, joystick. All right, I know you're clever. Mention 5 output devices. Yes, plotter, data projector, monitor, DVD player, printer. You're intelligent. And this will lead to our topic today, keyboard. All right, a keyboard is an input device, just as I've said earlier, is one of the examples. It's an input device that allows the computer user to key in or type in data or text or instruction. What did I say? A keyboard is an input device that allows the computer user to key in or type in data, text or instruction, right? Keyboard is a vital part of a computer. I do not say others are not important, but without the keyboard, one cannot enjoy operating the computer. Now, the keyboard, just as I have it here, the keyboard has different parts. We have the upper parts, as you can see, F1 to F12. Each of these keys does a specific job. We'll still read the topic. This is called function keys because it contains F1 to F12. We have the parts labeled A to Z. We call that alphabetical keys. We have the part labeled 1 to Z, 0 to 9. But here you see 1 to 0. I know you're asking why. We don't have 10. Any figure you want to type, you can take that from here, no matter how many digits number. Okay, now we have the arrow keys, and that's why we say even if you don't have your mouse, you can use the keyboard. This is also called directional key or scroll key. It helps you to navigate from a word to the other, line to the other, or jump from a page to the other. And we have other keys. I know you'll be imagining all these keys labeled caps lock, shift and control. They are all called special keys. As you can see, this is even the longest key in this keyboard. It is called spacebar key. Thank you very much. I know you have this at home. Importance of keyboarding. Having known the meaning of a keyboard, it is also important to know that if you don't have the expository knowledge of keyboard, you cannot do well while typing. The importance of keyboarding is as follows. One, it makes one acquire professional skills which are needed in a competitive workforce. What this means, if you are good in typing, you can work in any office that makes use of computer. Okay, and when you've acquired this professional skill, it means your boss won't always have problem with you because you are ready for any work. Okay, number two, it makes one confident. Of course, we know that knowledge is power. When you know how to do a particular thing, you always carry yourself around like the king or queen you are. So this will give you the confidence whenever you're called upon to type, you won't shiver. Three, it offers an opportunity for job recruitment. We know so many companies now recruit using computer. If you've acquired these professional skills, it means you are ready for any interview. You just enter the hall, sit, log in, answer question, submit log out, that's all. But when you've not acquired this skill, you know you've already failed. Number four, to make someone self-reliant and useful to himself. We have so many graduates now looking for white collar job. When you've not gotten any and you have a laptop, I think you can put food on your desk by carrying your laptop, place it on a desk, pay for a stand, type students' project, you get paid. Okay, number five. To individuals, it automatically makes you a tutor to others, and that's why it derives your living from it. We know this. Most of these cures, they pay these days for computers as a computer center. You go there, you see the O-level holders, they've been taught the computer, and when they've learned it, they'll be employed as a tutor there just to get their living while they wait for their admission. As well, when you earn your money through this, I think you'll be somehow balanced financially to an extent. Number six, to business, it makes work neat, fast, and accurate. I know you're following. Yes, during this pandemic period, I know some of you, before now, some of you have visited ShopRite, rubber stores, and other supermarkets. After selecting your goods, get to the pay stand, they will check it. You see those workers there, they have their laptops operating their keyboard to calculate. It makes it so fast and accurate. Now, when you type a work and there's a mistake, you can easily erase it, retype, it will make it neat. Number seven, it helps to save time and produce numerous or voluminous documents. We know that if you're fast in typing, typing 5 pages won't be up to 30 minutes, but when copying with your hand, using biro and note, it will take much time. That's what I mean. Hope you're following. Okay. Now let's move to correct sitting position. Okay. We are talking about correct sitting position. What I mean is the posture. How you expected to sit while typing. And you know, efficiency demands a stable table and chair, each at correct height for the typist or operator to be comfortable. Now, I want to show you the example. I want to demonstrate how the typist or the operator is supposed to sit while operating the computer. I know we say health is wealth. It's of no use after typing, working for your boss. The money you earn, you will now spend it in the hospital. So the following rules are supposed to be obeyed. In fact, they must be obeyed while typing to avoid backache, waist pain, and others. Number one, sit well back in a chair. This is your chair. Remember I said the chair and the desk will be at correct height. Sit well back in a chair. You can see that back erect. You don't need to relax as if you're in your bedroom. Sit this way. Then make sure your shoulders are down and back while you type. Are you seeing clearly? Okay, practice it now. Okay, you can see that. Number two, never cross your legs or wing them. You see my legs? Do not cross it this way. Of course, you know this is not the correct official sitting position. I know my students, they don't sit that way in the classroom. You see this way? Do not wind your leg across the chairs. Make sure your feet are on the floor. If you've not gained balance, place one slightly in front of the other. You can see that to gain balance. But your feet must be on the floor. Okay. Keep your fingers on the home key when you're not typing. Why we say this? You might be discussing with your colleague and you place your fingers on the alphabetical keys, on numerical keys. Mistakenly, a finger will strike and there must be an error. Because any key you strike here, the character must appear on the monitor. You can see that clearly. So, and while typing, make sure your fingers are curved. Of course, you don't just pick. You know, we don't pick like this. No. If you want to press J, you place this finger here. Your wrist is not expected to touch the frame. If not, it will strike the shift, the space bar key. Do you get that? All right. Now, close your mouth while typing. My students, they don't open their mouth unnecessarily. Why we say close your mouth while typing is to avoid saliva dropping on the keys. And you know, we avoid any form of liquid dropping on these keys. It's not supposed. All right, the next one is your arm should hang naturally. You know what I mean? That's what I said. It's not good to carry your laptop on your laps or you carry it up like this, just like a melodeon, and pick like this. No, you don't do that. Place it on this desk. The desk must have correct height. Now, while typing, since you've observed the correct sitting position, naturally, your arms must hang. When it will not hang is when you are carrying it here. There must be an error. You get that? Okay. Now, your eyes should be on the copy to be typed. Let's take this as a copy. You know, you've acquired the professional skill. You already know the keys. You've mastered the keys. Now, while typing, you should be looking at the copy you are to type to get the words correctly. Do you get that? Okay. So, while you practice this at home, get your parents' laptop or your siblings' laptop, do this. You won't complain of any pain. Just one of my friends, a roadside typist, always complained then about the backache, waist pain until I taught her this. So observe the rules. Now let's go back to the topic for today, keyboard. A keyboard is an input device that allows the computer user to key in or type in data, text, or instruction into the computer. We have the parts, as I've said earlier, function keys F1 to F12, alphabetical keys, letters A to Z, numerical keys labeled 0 to 9, directional keys, that's the arrow keys, the special keys, example control keys, key, shift key, caps lock, and others. We talked about the importance of keyboarding. As I've said, if you've not acquired this skill, you won't do perfect in this field. Therefore, you have to acquire the skill to enable you have your confidence. Anytime you're called upon to type, you do that. It will help you in earning your living while you still wait for white collar job as graduates. Now, at your stage, it will even help you when you come back to school. You might help the typist at your leisure time to type. It is somehow fun. Now, we talked about you having been self-reliant, be on your own, foot your bill, do whatever thing you want to do without begging someone to help you type and paying that person. Okay, we talked about the sitting position. Remember, it might be funny, but always close your mouth while typing and keep your eyes on the copy to be typed. Sit well, do not cross your legs, do not wean them, get balance. If you are not yet balanced, place the other slightly in front. I mean, your feet must be on the floor. Why one is slightly in front of the other? Your arms should hang naturally. Do not carry your laptop on your laps. Thank you very much. Now take your assignment. Hope you're ready. Hope you also enjoy the class. Okay, take down your assignment. Are you ready? Okay. Discuss the care of the computer. Discuss the care of the computer. Thank you very much. Stay safe. Remember, coronavirus is real and always obey your parents. Keep typing at home to make you acquire these professional skills. Thank you.